Hallelujah. So we want to read the word of God from the book of Numbers 16, verse 9. And that verse, and then we will go to Isaiah 49, verse chapter 49, verse 5 to 6. And I will read the two verses together by the grace of God. And it shall come to, and it seemed a small thing. Let me ask, repeat again. Is it a small thing to you that the God of Israel has separated you from the congregation of Israel to bring you near to him to do the works of tabernacle of the Lord and to stand before the congregation to serve him? Let me repeat it again. I want this to get into your mind. Is it a small thing to you that the God of Israel has separated you to the congregation of Israel to bring you near to himself to do the works of tabernacle of the land of the Lord, and to stand before the congregation to serve them? Then let's go to Isaiah 49, verse 5, chapter verse 9, 49, chapter 49, verse 5 to 6. And the Lord says, who formed me from the womb to be a servant, to bring Jacob back to him, so that Israel is gathered to him, for I shall be glorious in the heights of the Lord, and my God shall be my strength. Indeed, he says, is it too small a thing that you should be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the preserved one of Israel? I will also give you as light to the Gentiles, that you should be my salvation to the head of the earth. Dear Heavenly Father, Princess Lord, I thank you and honor you, King of all glory. So deliver your word, King of Kings, I align my mind to your mind, I align my spirit to your spirit. As I speak the oracle that you've given unto me, Father, let this word come to your people. Let him encourage them, Lord. Where we need to be rebuked, Lord, we accept your rebuke. And Lord Almighty, where we want to be guided, Lord Almighty, we accept your guidance. You do this, Lord, for your own glory. And as your servant, we will be complete. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. The title of my message today is, it is not a small thing. It is not a small thing. When we show people doing small things, when we see people doing small things in the ministry that the Lord has called them, sometimes we wonder, is this man called? Is this woman called? Hallelujah. When you see people are not making it in life, in their ministries, you wonder, you start judging them and saying, I don't think this man was called. When you see men backsliding, and yet they are servants of God, and you start blaming them and say, this man, this woman was not called. But I've come with a message today to remind you, what is in you is not a small thing. It is not a small thing. What the Lord put in you is not a small thing. Hallelujah. The ministry that the Lord has put you is not a small thing. Why are you borrowing me money? Can you are a pastor? Tell him or her, can't get ministries. We can't get anointing. People may not see it. They may not even realize that we can't sell them. But because they will not see it, I have come to remind you as a fellow servant, what you carry is not a small thing. Is it a small thing? Is it a small thing to you that the God of Israel has separated you from the congregation of Israel? God picked you from many. He will pick someone else. Why did you pick you? And it was not a small thing for God to choose you from many people. And it was not a small thing for God to come into your father's house, to back to your mother's father.
Diminish ourselves again. We will not diminish the ministry that you are putting us again. We are not the one.
have declared we are not small things, and it is not a small thing to be who we are today. We are not small things. The vision that we carry is not small for us to be here today. And it took somebody to trust you, and it took somebody to separate you. You did not pick up yourself and come. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hey. Wow.
When I remember the job that I left, it reminds me, this thing is not a small thing. When you remember the business you left, it reminds you, this thing is not a small thing. When you remember the luxuries that you are separating yourself from and setting yourself aside as a lot, you remember, this thing is not a small thing. A thing that is separating you from good friends. A thing that is separating you from the big hotels where you can dine, you can drink beer, you can do all kind of things. It is not a small thing that can separate you. Some of you are entrepreneurs, or maybe you were entrepreneurs before. Some of you are employed. Hallelujah. I worked on two jobs. One job was forced by my father to be a soldier. I stepped out and I went to do medical. And the job I left at NIS Health Center, internet, it is 250,000. Here I'm not paid, but I operate like someone who is operating with millions. Because what is in me, it was not a small thing. Whoever gives it, it will provide. It is not a small thing. When it comes, it pays the bills. So why should you be worried? How quit because I'm not able to pay the mortgage? How quit because I'm not able to feed my family? How quit this thing? Was it the will of God for me to be a minister? Yes, I've come to tell you it was the will of God, because what He put in you, what He saw in you, was not a small thing. And small things, it was not a small thing. People who carry greatness, they start small. They grow. You give it time to grow. I'm a businesswoman. I have several businesses. And none of my businesses started like, they started small. But because the Lord had ordained my businesses to become big companies, He made sure I will stick to the calling. I will stick to the business. What it is going to happen up now, I will stick into it. I come to tell a servant of God who is giving up, stick to that ministry. If it is falling down, stick to it. If it is going up, stick to it. Because it is in the intentions of the Lord that you start with that ministry, because it was not a small thing. It is not a hobby to do. It is not a political seat. It is not a parliamentary seat that lasts for 5 years. This thing lasts for lifetime. It lasts for lifetime. You better prepare yourself. Sometimes you are built and move, because this thing is not a small thing. It is not lasting tomorrow. It is not lasting for 1 year. It is not lasting for 2 years. It is lasting for a lasting, because it was given to them. It is not lasting for short time. and steal outside there. It will become a small thing. Go and sleep with people, however. It shall become a small thing. People will diminish. People will see you like nothing. But if it is a small thing, can you carry it with righteousness? Can you carry it with vigor? Can you carry it with a lot of vigor? Because what you are carrying is not a small thing. Something small. When you want to make it something small, it will become small in the span of seconds. I'm so mad because I was counseling another couple. And you may have your seat. And these people, it was a very pathetic case. A servant of God comes, and the wife is expectant. And even before then, he told me, we want to disclose these things to you. We will not disclose them to our spiritual authority. We want you to pray for us. And the wife could not agree it. Kasi ma, di posa tu wame imanu maisha, wache hinda nusikana na usika hakuche. Hallelujah. And the leader hakuja, sema vile uliambiwa na pastor. Akasema aliniambia, wewe, upeani ya sex, na ulikatai maneno kabisa, na kaniambia ta wasee wa kanisa na viongozi wa kanisa, wampea ruhusa aende. Sasa kaniambia, alikuwa naomba ni muokole. If you want to put this thing a small thing, it will become a small thing. You are the members of your church who used to see what you carry as a big thing, who used to see you as a big person, they will see you as a small thing, like a twinkling of an eye. The things will change. But it is my prayer today as a servant of Kitegala, we shall value what the Lord has put in us. Whatever He separated us to do, we shall do it for the glory of the Lord. We shall not make this thing a small thing. We will not make this thing a small thing. I decree and declare our lives, we shall not make it a small thing. In Jesus' name.
Love.